Hello everyone, I am Anuja, I am from Legal Edge, and today I have some great people with me here to have this wonderful discussion with you today. So I'll ask them to introduce themselves to you. Malika, we can start with you.
Alright, hello ma'am, this is Malika Agarwal. I am currently in my third year at Government Law College, Mumbai. So I have done my preparation for CLAT as well as MHCET from Legal Edge. And then I appeared for the same in 2018. And so now today I'm at GLC.
That's great. Okay. Simran, I think you can go. Okay, Ashra, yeah.
Hello, I am also on the same page as Malika. We are in the 2018-23 batch of Government Law College, Mumbai.
So you guys are batchmates, right?
Yes, okay. Ma'am.
I am in the fourth year of GLC, 2021 batch. I did my preparation from Legal Edge Bhopal in 2016.
Great. Okay. And?
Hi, I'm Ishika. I am in the second year of Government Law College, Mumbai. And I got enrolled in a two-year program at Legal Edge, and I appeared for it in the last year along with my board.
So guys, as you can see, all of them are from GLC Mumbai, which is a very reputable college for sure, because it's the oldest one. It has this glorious history with it. And we have students from different years. So you can see this senior-junior equation right here, right now, how the culture of college is. So any of you can probably tell me the coolest thing about your college, the thing which is which, you know, your juniors would like to know, the culture, the timings, the kind of assignments you get.
I would like to take over it.
Yeah, okay.
So ma'am, the best thing which I felt is, like, we are in the field of law, and for us, like, bookish knowledge is important, but more than bookish knowledge, it's all about practical knowledge. And as there's no academic burden on students of GLC, like, we have lectures, but like for senior years, it gets over by 11 o'clock or 10:30 something.
What, so over by 10:30? What?
Yes, ma'am. Yeah.
When then what time do you start?
7:30, I guess.
7:30? So it's a college for morning people?
Yes. For the senior batches. Like, so we begin our core law subjects from the third year of our studies. Like, for the first 2 years, we study the subjects of BA, BBA, whatever it is. Mm-hmm. So then from the third year, we start for law. So after 10:30, 11, they have ample time. So we can all intern throughout the year. So that's what becomes a plus point for us over the students of other colleges. So we can do as many as internships as we can. Mm-hmm. And then the regarding the culture, so there are many student-run committees going on in the school, say placement cell, MUN circuit, DepSoc, cultural committees. There are many committees. So we are involved there. Then there's junior-senior relationship. Seniors are always there as helping hands for us. So we can approach them like for any time. So for us, more than professors, seniors are there always to help us. So that's something I like much about GLC. Taking others can continue then.
You can go ahead, Simrindi.
No, it's okay. It's okay.
My first year recently, and so in the last 1 year, what I felt the most. The best part about GLC was it's so easy to approach your seniors, and though the professors and the curriculum is very lacking, what I personally feel is you can always contact your seniors regarding anything, be it MOOCs or study notes or anything. So all my seniors have helped me a lot in the past 1 year, and so there's no formality. I had heard ki काफी ragging होती है वगैरह, but ऐसा कुछ भी नहीं होता GLC में. You don't need to in case you ever come to GLC, you would find people sitting, seniors and juniors relaxing on Marine Drive and chilling. So that's something which I don't think other college students get to have. So yeah, that's for sure.
Okay, all right.
Also, I would like to add to this. So, with regard to the academic pressure, since we don't have too much academic pressure, we can actually explore a lot of options. So there are students who are preparing for judiciary, who are preparing for UPSC, who are doing other courses like CA and CS. So you get a lot of time for that as well, which is a great benefit.
Yeah, you have all the time. And are there some good coachings or maybe, places where you can approach teachers nearby? I mean, is it conveniently situated?
Yeah, one of the main best feature about the GLC would be this only. It is located just in front of Churchgate Station, which is the most amazing place in Mumbai. So the location and it is so situated that on just around 500 meters, less than 500 meters, we have Bombay High Court. Another 500 meters, we have Marine Drive. Another just in front of our college, we have Churchgate Station. A single train from that station takes us to like major hub, Dadar and all, where we can find all the coaching for CA, CS, judiciary.
Yes.
And so this is how like GLC helps in other things as well.
The connection. So you're right in the middle of the action, right? You
are, yeah.
Yes. Achha, guys, I need to ask you this, and especially what a tier 2 student like yourself would like to know, because I know that you are all from places like Bhopal, in essence. And when you shifted to Mumbai, that's like, definitely a big change. So what was the most shocking thing or the scariest thing or, whichever way you see it?
I would like to take on this. When I came to Mumbai for the first time, this was the first time I went to Mumbai. So it took me a month to shift to Mumbai because it was to find a proper flat, because the hostel in Mumbai in our college is not so proper. So it took a month to me, and I stayed in dormitory near the CST station. So it was there was an experience that to stay with me for life, like to go to college and to look for two flats in a day, then come back to a dormitory and stay with some random people, then again go with the same thing tomorrow.
So I think it already made you a lot more independent, right?
Yeah, the culture in Mumbai, like in education as well, is very much against spoon feeding. Nobody teaches you what to do. Nobody asks you to do anything. They just throw you in the ocean, then you need to figure out it all yourself.
Yeah, nice analogy.
But then actually, everybody is really ready to help always. Even though you have to figure things out on your own, you can ask to anybody for help, and everybody is always ready. Whether it's Bombay or whether it's GLC, everybody is ready to help.
Yes, that's one thing that's famous about Mumbaikers, yeah. So, Maulika, Ishika, anything to say here? Or anything, any advice that you would give to your younger self? Because, you just wish that if you knew this a year back or a couple of years back, you would have done better.
So, for me, it was when I came to GLC, I'd heard that साउथ बॉम्बे वाले बच्चे बहुत ज्यादा एटीट्यूड होता है एंड इट्स टफ टू अप्रोच देम फॉर एनीथिंग सो एंड इन दिस वन ईयर आई गॉट टू नो दैट इट्स दैट दे आर नॉर्मल पीपल एंड यू नो एंड आई वाज वेरी इंटिमिडेटेड व्हेन आई यूज्ड टू टॉक टू देम बट ड्यूरिंग द स्पैन ऑफ वन ईयर आई अंडरस्टूड दैट नो देयर्स नो सच थिंग एंड एवरीबॉडी इज ऑलवेज रेडी टू हेल्प यू आउट. Just that you need to contact the right person, and the work's done.
Yes, that's the trick. Okay. So, you took this exam called MHCET, right? Get where you are. So, I am sure there are a lot of aspirants this year as well who are preparing for MHCET. And I think who better than you to tell them the reality of it, what to prepare, what to do, and more importantly, what not to do. So, what will be those words of advice that we can start with the senior most? Maybe Simran can tell us the kind of things that aspirants should have in mind.
So, one thing I've noticed with respect to MHCET is that the students take it very lightly. They think that if they are giving CLAT, they can easily give MHCET, they'll clear it and everything. Though MHCD is at an easier level with respect to CLAT, but there is a lot of competition, especially with respect to the outside Maharashtra students. We just have 10% seats for the outside Maharashtra students. And like I remember in when I gave MHCD, there were 3 lists which had people in my score. So 3 lists had people who scored the exact same score that I did, but they were differentiated because of their 12%. So I think even a point, even 1 mark would matter a lot in that case.
Yes, yes. And in any easy exam, I think this is a very important point that you have raised, that competition is very cutthroat. So you need to take it seriously. Yeah. Yes. Okay. What else?
I think the exam's not very tough, and what it requires is the basic, is that you really need to have your basics clear. So for me, what helped was I had my basics very clear, be it English, be it logical reasoning. And instead of preparing for just 1 month and taking it lightly, I would recommend students to study throughout the year or whatever their preparation period be. And I think, and also not... and not take too much fluke, because I think even on 1 mark, we have 20-30 students. So the competition is really cut through. So, yeah.
Any preparation tips?
Yeah, another thing about the preparation, like I believe that instead of preparing from an examination point of view, we should try to make ourselves better. That's the point of examination as well. Because some days back, I again have to refer to my grammar books. So because of some, I was writing something and I went back, I was reviewing something and I thought, this is a grammatical error. Then I have to go back. So if I was more clear at that point of time, it would have helped me today.
Happy you do that. I'm glad you mentioned it.
Critical reasoning is something at which I was not so good earlier. I read 2 books after coming to college, and now I feel that it is something which is more helping me.
So it is that constant quest that you are in, and you just want to improve, not just for the examination sake, but for improving your personality per se, right? So that is what you should have in mind. Well said. Malika, adding something? No, not really.
No, not actually, ma'am. I agree with them what they said. And then, like, there should no particular preparation for MHCT. It goes same with the CLAT preparation. But then again, the same thing is, as we don't have negative marking here, so students go like taking it or considering it to be a slight easier than CLAT. But then the thing is, if the exam is easy, then the competition raises very high. Like, when I gave my exam, so I was having 12 other students with the same score as me. So if they are not dropping, like if they are not choosing any other college over GLC, so there are high chances that my name would have cut off from the list, because as the rule says, there are out of 240 seats for the students outside Maharashtra, we get only 24 seats. So like, for students residing outside Maharashtra, we need to work very, very hard for it, because our cutoff goes around 115 plus out of 150. So we have to work hard for it. So, like, basically, what I wanted to say is, they should not take MHCT as an easier exam. Also, they should simultaneously prepare for it well.
Yes, keep the competition in mind, guys. Because out of Maharashtra, students are only 10%. I mean, do you see some diversity issues in your college? Most of them are from one place and then you feel like an outsider. Does that happen?
Exactly not, ma'am. I never felt. Like, I have my friends from proper Mumbai as well. Some are OMS students, like outside Maharashtra also. Some from Maharashtra as well. So I never felt that, it goes well with everyone. It is how you are gelling with them, it goes that way. So it is not at all difficult.
Okay.
And another thing about
diversity is, even if you don't know Marathi, they help you understand and learn Marathi, so that, you know, you don't left out in the outside the college.
Yeah.
So that's something which I really
like. And it's
really
a pretty easy language to pick up, right? I believe, I mean, I'm not fluent myself, but I understand bits and pieces, and I believe that it's fairly easy to pick up.
I don't know, ma'am. Like, I have not still learned in 2 years. But yes, there's this thing goes on that being government college and that too in Maharashtra. So people would generally say ki atmosphere pura tumhe Marathi milega ye wo. And like we being from Madhya Pradesh and then I'm particularly Marwadi, so I have no relation with Marathi. But when I entered college, there's nothing like this. Like in the office staff also, they speak English. Professors, I have never heard Marathi from professors or anyone. So like I never felt communication problem anywhere.
Another thing about diversity is that the Mumbai as a city itself is very diverse. So we people in Mumbai itself. So it makes a city completely diverse. So it's not needed another reservation or something from outside.
That's a wonderful point that absolutely kills my point. And I mean, very, very well pointed out that it's a melting pot in itself. So when I say people from Maharashtra, they're very diverse, as diverse as they can get. So quite feeling of pride that you must be having that you are studying in a college where the likes of Baba Ambedkar and our former president, and I mean, who all can I name all the prestigious people who have walked in the same alleyways in your college where you do the same thing? So,
ma'am, it's a nice feeling, right? B.R. Ambedkar, it's Pratibha Patil, then Ram Jethmalani, and many of the chief justices of India have been the student professor. So yes. There are many, like we have a very strong alumni base from GLC. And another thing, like as I mentioned in the earlier, like when you started the session, so as we don't have academic burden, so we have like all the freedom to go for other things. Like we have been continuously mooting. Then students go in the fields like wherever they are interested. Some are going for ADRs, some are going for debates, then mootings. Also, like I myself, I'm pursuing CS as well simultaneously with law. So I don't think studying in other colleges, because they have already a very hectic academic schedule. So after that,
yes.
They can't prefer studying for CS or any other subjects. At the same time, our college provides diploma courses in cyber laws or other things. So we do that as well. So like we can explore everything around when you are at GLC. So that's the plus point. Like I was ready to give up NLU for GLC.
That's really good. I think that sells it for me. So any final words from any of you before we call this one a day?
One of the most important thing that is left out so far in our talk is that the location which I was talking about earlier. What happens with the college location is that some of us usually go hanging around in Bombay High Court. It's so near to us that we can go and chill in Bombay High Court. The legends of the bar, the amazing lawyers, one of the best bar is in Bombay. So we usually go hear cases, some of the best lawyers arguing, seeing them, and sometimes we even get in talks with them. We can talk to multiple lawyers in a single day. And they are mostly happy to engage us. So that's something which no other college can provide that GLC can.
That's remarkable. The kind of ambience, yes.
Also, I would like to add to this, the most of the law firms are also situated nearby. Like they are very accessible.
Yes.
So once, like for the senior years, starting from the third year, one can attend their classes, then directly head to their internship. They can intern throughout the year. Which I don't think the students of other colleges get this kind of opportunity to intern.
And Simran, just does this GLC tag help in getting you internship faster? You have that kind of goodwill?
Yes, I'm sure.
Yes,
to an extent,
it does. So actually, our alumni base is very strong, and you will get a lot of people from GLC everywhere. The High Court and most of the firms. So, we get a better opportunity than other students in this
Definitely.
The internship regarding question is that is yours. So, the thing is, like, we can go to a law firm directly and we can ask them about position available in the month which is not available to another student. Like for example, when in the month of March, other people will be having their classes, you can just go and talk to an associate or an advocate to have internship, and then we can have internship as long as 3 months, 4 months, 6 months. Some of our seniors are continuously interning at the same place for 2 years. They get their breaks during exam, but that's something which is remarkable for us to have continuously long internship in a single place at a single firm. So very eases the chance of a PPO at that firm or at that place.
Otherwise, people usually get a month there or maybe maximum a couple of months, and that's all. Right.
And ma'am, it is when students of other law colleges appear for internships, so that is precisely month of May or June when they get their semester breaks. But that time, all the law colleges have their summer breaks, so positions are not, students are many, but positions are not available. Yeah. And we can relax at that time, and we can intern for January to April continuously. And this is very helpful for us for our fourth and fifth years when they are looking for long-term interns, which other college students cannot do. We can do long-term internships for 4 months, 5 months.
Definitely.
And ma'am, second point which GLC helps is almost all the firms, the heads who are the founders of the firms, precisely almost all of them are the alumni from our college itself. So
that
gives us a better hand.
So your seniors have done the job for you. They've set the benchmark. So. So guys, it was wonderful talking to all of you, and I believe that whoever is going to watch this is going to learn a lot and get really excited about coming to your college and interacting with you and doing the sort of things that you are doing. So thank you so much for taking out time to be with us today, and I think on this point we are calling it a day here. So thank you so much.